Good morning, my dear students. I hope you all are fine and good at home. And I think you all are working very hard. Okay. As your exam has already been gone, you have just given the half yearly examination. Your result is going to be declared soon. And we have already completed the chapter fraction. Okay. The last chapter which we have completed was fraction. So I think and I hope that no problem you have faced in that chapter, and we can smoothly move to the next chapter. And today the next chapter which we are going to begin is number and patterns. So let's move on and just see, my dear. So students, we are going to start, okay? So that is chapter number 14 which we are going to start today. So see, my dear, here it is written number pattern. Okay, so this is only the chapter which we are going to start. Okay, as I have told, means the chapter name number is 14 that we are going to begin. So let's just see that what are the things which we are going to learn in this chapter. First, let's just see that what is pattern. Pattern, the way your number change. Okay, the way your numbers change, okay, means how you are changing the number, that is pattern. Sequence, the set of a number you see after you follow our pattern, means whatever set of number is given, according to that only we used to follow the pattern. These two statement will be much more clear to us when we will move with some of the examples which I am going to give you today. This is one kind of pattern is given, isn't it? In this pattern, you can see, my dear, one square box is there, one circle is there, and one triangle is there. So this is the pattern given, and in the same way, three patterns are given. Means this is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. So three of the patterns are given. Okay, but in all the three patterns, we can see one square is there. One circle is there and one triangle is there. The pattern is going continuously the same. No change is there in the pattern. In this pattern, student, it is given. You can see what it is given, how this pattern is given. You are thinking that this what it is, what dots are given in this boxes. Just see. One time it is in increasing order given. One time two, then again one is increasing, it will be three. Then again one increasing, it is 4. Then again one it is increasing, that is 5. So like this, every time it is increasing one by one. Means 1, 1 it is increasing. 2, 3, 4, 5. Like this it is increasing. Okay, it is increasing every time. Okay, so this is one of the pattern which is given. The dots are increasing by 1. Okay, now just see the next one. In this pattern, you can see, my dear, it is written ABA, BAB, AB. Okay? Can you guess which kind of pattern we are following? The pattern of AA and BB we are following. Just see. See. A and A. Okay? B and B. So AB, AB, then again AB. Then again AB. Means AB, AB pattern we are following. Means A and A in that. In two, between two A's, in the middle there is B. Okay, in the same way, between two A's, there is in the middle B. Okay, that also you can see. Between two A's, there in the middle is B. So this is the pattern which we are following in this part, in this example which I have opened here. One more pattern I have opened, my dear. In this you can see the pattern, the apples. Shape, the shape of the apple which are drawn, in that you must see that 2, then again it is increasing by 2, then it is 4, then again it is increasing by 2, then it is 6, then again it is increasing by 2, then it is 8, and in the same way it is going on till 16. So here one thing, have you observed one thing? What observe? We have observed that numbers which are written in the pattern, they are in the multiples of 2. Means 2, 2, 2 every time we are adding. So 2, 2, 2 in the table of 2 also. 2, 1 is a 2, 2, 2 is a 4, 2, 3 is a 6. Like this also we can do. And or else
we can do by adding also, means when you will add 2 in the 2 in the first 2, then you will get 4, then again when you will add, then 6, then again when you will add, then 8, then again when you will add, then 10, and like this it is carrying on. So it means that here we are adding 2 every time. Here we are adding 2 each and every time. Okay, so the numbers are given in the table form of 2 and the 2, like this also you can see, or we can say every time in the number which is given, in that number I am adding 2. Okay, so this is also one of the pattern. That time we were adding, my dear. Now here we are subtracting. What we are doing? We are subtracting. Like 40 is there. So 40 minus 4 we are doing. Then 36. Then 36 minus 4. Then 32. Then 32 minus 4, 28. 28 minus 4, 24. 24 minus 4, 20. And 20 minus 4 is 16. Like this, each and every time we are subtracting 4 from the given number. We are subtracting 4 from the given number. Okay, so this is in the table of, the pattern is in the table of 2, in the table of 4. This pattern which we are dealing right now, this pattern is in the form in the table of 4. So in the table of 4, from the back when we are starting, from 10, okay, 4 tens are 40, 4 nines are 36, 4 is the 32, 4 7 the 28, 4 6 the 24, like this it is going on. Now we are going to discuss some more kind of patterns which may come in numbers or which may can come in figures also. We have discussed right now about the figures also. We have discussed some of the numbers also, like by adding 2 or by subtracting 4 or by making the square, triangle and circle in one box. This kind, some of the patterns we have already discussed. Now we will move on. Just see. Here, my dear, you can see what it is written. It is written rule number 1, which we used to follow when we are writing any number or anything on a pattern. An arithmetic sequence can be made by adding or subtracting the same value each time. Whenever we are working on a pattern or in a sequence, then every time we either used to add or we used to subtract anything. Okay, of the same value. It is not like that we are one time adding 3, then another time we are adding 4, and another time we are adding 5. No. Each and every time we are adding the same kind of number right now. We used to add different numbers also. It used to happen that one time we are adding 1, then again another time we are adding 2, then 3, like this also we are adding. Other different numbers also we used to add. But some of the time in the sequence we used to add the same or we used to subtract the same. In the same way you can see, like 1, then 4, then 7, then 10, then 13. Then 16, like this it is given. So every time from 1 to 4 when we are jumping, then we are adding 3 in that. From 4 to 7 when you are jumping, again you are adding 3. From 7 to 10 you are jumping, then again adding 3. Then again from 10 to 13 when you are jumping, then again adding 3. And like this only every time we are moving on. So here in the sequence you are seeing, every time we are adding the same number. Which number we are adding? Only 3 we are adding each and every time. Okay, this was the first rule which we have discussed. In rule number 2, my dear, what it is written, it is written again, the same thing is written, but that was we have done on the basis of addition. If there we were adding +3 +3, here what we are doing, it is written 14, then 15, then 16, then 17, then 18. Means it is going in decreasing order. So means every time from 14 to 15 when we are going, okay, then minus 2, then again from 15 to 17 when we are going, means from 13 to 15 when you are going, then again you are subtracting 2, then again from 15 to 17 you are going, again you are subtracting 2, again from 17 to 19 you are going, you are again subtracting 2, then again from 19 to 21 you are going, then again subtracting 2, and 21 to 23 you are going, then again subtracting 2, then again 23 to 25 you are going, then again subtracting 2. It means that in this pattern there is a difference between each and every number of 2. The difference between is 2. And for finding that difference, we are every time we are subtracting, for going in that sequence, for completing that sequence, for going in, for making that the number sequence complete, we are every time subtracting 2, 2, 2 from each and every number. Like from 13, if we are subtracting 2, then we are getting, sorry, from 25 when we are subtracting 2, then we are getting 23. Then 23 we are subtracting 2, then we are getting 21. Then 21 when we are subtracting 2, then we are getting 19. And from 19 when we are subtracting 2, then 17. Then 17 subtracting 2, then 15. And like this we are moving on. Now I am with after addition and subtraction. Already I have given 2 examples from addition and subtraction. Now we will move on with the multiplication. What there it is written? An arithmetic sequence can made by multiplying or dividing the same value each time. Okay, same value means by multiplying. There we are discussing about the multiplication. So how we are doing this? Just see. 1 into 3 is 3, then again 3 into 3 is 3, means every time with which number you are multiplying? With 3 only. Every time the answer which I am getting with that, in that every time I am multiplying with 3, means 3 into 1 when I am multiplying, then 3. Then from that, on that 3 again I am multiplying 3, then 9. Then again in 9 I am multiplying 3, then 27. Then in that 27, I am multiplying 3. Then I am getting 81. So this is also one of the pattern in which with the same number, that is 3, by number 3, we are multiplying each and every product whatever we are getting. Product you are knowing now, when two numbers are multiplied, the answer which we used to get, that is the product. So 1 into 3 is 3. So 3 is the product here. So again, the from the in the whatever the product you are getting, from in that product, you will multiply 3. Then you will get 6. Then again in that product you will multiply 3, then you will get 9. Then in that product you will multiply 3, then you will get 27. Like this, this pattern is going on. So this is the number which we are getting. Okay. Now we are here with the arithmetic sequence which can be made by multiplying and dividing the same value of number. So here we are dividing. There we are multiplied. Here we are dividing 2. Okay, here we are dividing 2. So 160 is the number given. 160 divided by 2 is 80. Then again 80 divided by 2 is 40. And 40 divided by 2 is 20. And 20 divided by 2 is 10. And then 10 divided by 2 is 5. Okay, like this we are moving on. If again the 5 also you will divide, then you will get the answer. 5 is not divided. We have not divided. Okay, because the answer will come in decimal. So that there only we have left. So here you can see with the same number, that is 2. Okay, with the same number, that is 2 which is given. With that only we are multiplying each and every time. With that number we are dividing each and every time. Means whatever the here, whatever the question which you are getting, whatever the question, when you are dividing, you are not getting the remainder here. You will get only the question. So whatever that question you are getting, in that question you have to divide 2. Then again in that question which you are getting, in that question you have to divide 2. And like this only you have to move on. Like this only you have to move on. So like that only I have done. 160 divided by 2, then 80, and then in the same sequence I am going. I have not changed any of the number. Every time I have divided with the same number, that is 2. Okay, and then I have got the question. Okay, this is also one of the pattern. So many patterns we have discussed. By adding also, by subtracting also, by multiplying also, by dividing also. So many different patterns you will get. Even the shape pattern also you can get. Okay, the different shapes also can be given. According to that shape, you have to make one pattern. So you have to see that. Okay, this is also one thing which we should see. That what it is written. It is written, an arithmetic sequence can be made by multiplying or dividing 10, 100 or 1000, etc. Means like 128 is given. 128 by 10, then by 100 and by 1000. One time we will divide by each and every. Sorry, we will multiply. Here we are multiplying. Na? So we will multiply. So when 128 is multiplied with 10, then 1280 you will get. When it will be multiplied with 100, then the zero will increase in the last. Then when it is multiplied with 1000, then the zero will increase in the last. Okay, then if it is multiplied by 10,000, again nothing will happen much, only the numbers of zero will increase in the last. Okay, so this is how, this is also one of the pattern in which we are multiplying the given number with 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, like this. Okay, here in this it is written, an arithmetic sequence can be made by dividing or multiplying 10, 100, and 1000, etc. So dividing means the number which is given, we have to divide that number. Okay, so that number we had, when we are dividing, like 1, 2, 8, 0, 0, 0, 000 divided by 10, then it will be 12, 1, 2, 8, 00. Okay, means 10 will be cut. Okay, in the same way, when you will divide by 100, then the 2 zeros will cut. Here the number of there, when we are multiplying, what is happening? The numbers of zeros were increasing. Here what is happening? The numbers of zeros were decreasing, because here we are dividing with the same number, we have multiplied also with the same number, but when the when we used to multiply, okay, the number used to increase, whereas when we used to divide, the number used to decrease. Okay, so when we are multiplying this number, the same number, then every time it is increasing, but when we are dividing with the same number, it is decreasing one time. Okay, so pattern can come in any form. It is not specific that, miss, you have said only by 2 it will be, we have to divide, or by 3 only we have to divide. Now it is 100. Pattern can come in any form. You just have to see and go through that which kind of pattern is being given to you and how you have to solve it. You have to apply your brain there. You have to apply your wisdom there, that how we can solve this. Like if the number is given like divide this number by this, then you are already knowing that it is also one kind of pattern. So every time you have to just decrease 110 from the given number. The same thing I have done. Like the number which is given is this one. I have just one time cut the number. I have one time cut the number. Okay. When I am dividing with 1000, 10 has been cut. When by 100, then 10 has been cut. Then 2 zeros has been cut. And again, when by 10, then 3 zeros has been cut. Then only 1, 2, 8 we have got. Okay, when we are dividing with 10, okay, when we are dividing, 10 has been cut. When by 100, 2 zeros has been cut. When by 1000, 3 zeros has been cut. Means the number of zeros are just decreasing. Means we are removing that. Whereas when we are multiplying the same, we are adding up the number of zeros. So that is all, my dear. I hope with the given examples here, it is just about the pattern. The pattern can be given in shapes also. Here you will get the patterns in number basically. Okay, you will get the patterns in number basically. You will get. I hope you will go and you will see, you will watch nicely how different patterns I have given on division and addition, on multiplication, and so many things I have explained. So when you will go through all the examples, you will be able to solve all kinds of questions. If it is given in the multiplication form, it is given in division form, it is given in addition, subtraction, any form. That is all, my dear. Thank you, everyone.